established stand-up comedians. He's certainly one of the industry's and also one of the industry's rising stars next to him, and you can catch both of them at the Cape Town Baxter Theatre from tomorrow until the 22nd of January, and as the rising star performs as the opening act for the veteran, if you could say that way. Please put your hands together, ladies and gentlemen, with the warmest express a welcome for comedians Nick Rabinowitz and Lindy Johnson! Yes, yes, the rising star and the veteran. Unbelievable. Nick, Lindy, thanks for joining us this morning.
Thank you so much for having me.
This must be very, very exciting to you.
It is. It's always exciting getting up at 4 a.m. I love it.
The sarcasm in there was thick. But Nick, dry white, eh? It's going to be happening. We saw the post. Why do you laugh every time? I'm trying to promote the show. Yo, like it's supposed to be, says dry white. Okay? A lot of people have seen this in the streets, hanging on poles. And wondering, why is that guy naked in the poster?
Yeah.
So tell me about the creative behind this and how it relates to the show.
You know, it was day zero. Yeah. People were like, you can't use your shower. You need to buy one of those horticultural sprayers, you know, that create the fine mist. And then you'd be standing day zero. That's what would happen. We'd all the white people would be under a bottle of Chardonnay waiting for... and they would just be dry and white and hence... dry white.
Yeah, but tell me, what do you discuss more than your luxurious showers under a bottle of Chardonnay? What's the content of this?
Well, unfortunately for me, it rained, and then Eskom also rained on my jokes, so now I've got to discuss other things.
Yeah. So you have to like, reshape the entire show?
Yeah, that everything. Okay. I've got to talk about transgender issues, staying woke post 40.
Have you?
As a white cisgender male, it's almost as challenging as staying awake post 40. I discuss when the land should be given back.
Wow. Mm. Wow. So a part of me wanted to ask you when, but then I realized that we can't go into that debate. It could be a very lengthy discussion.
Yeah. That's another day zero.
Which brings me to Lindy. How did your relationship with Nick get started and how your journey in comedy as well?
Well, I started at where all Cape Town comics start, at Armchair. So Nick saw me there, and then our relationship started from there. And then he was like, you know, I need this girl on my team because I'm an old white man, and she would help me and that kind of thing. So
she's not lying. He has pointed
it's
a lot of the privilege and prejudice.
I'm an old white man. Please help me.
That's not you. No, that's not me.
That's not Nick. That is you, though.
Yes, yeah. That is
Tell me about this moment with Trevi.
This was Nationwide at Joburg. I was chosen one of 13 by Trevor Noah to perform for the whole of South Africa. He just wanted to introduce who we thought was talented enough to showcase who South Africa needs to get to know as a young comic, which is probably the biggest gig of my life, including when I opened for Nick
Rabinowitz. It's fine. I'll take second place. It's fine.
And tell me about how has your comedy evolved in the time that you've been involved, especially doing shows like this, exposing you to a much bigger audience? Because, I mean, now this is international.
Yes. Well, I think when you start as a comic, you first get the hang of it. What is stand-up comedy? How to perform on stage? How to relax on stage? And now I'm enjoying comedy so much more because I'm learning what my voice is, what people want to hear from me as a young colored woman. Because there aren't many of us in comedy. There's like three colored women. So I have to represent.
And two of them are pretending to be Afrikaans.
Oh my gosh. Mm. Oh wow, Nick. Just out here with why must you be exposing people's mandates like
I'm joking.
No, wow. Okay. I hope so.
I'm not joking.
What is it that made you want to pull Lindy into to the show?
Ooh, look at that smile. How can you resist that smile, firstly? Secondly, then the funny comes out. Yeah. I don't know if you watched it, but this woman's hilarious.
Yeah.
And she's a new, fresh voice.
Yeah, yeah.
And she's delightful.
Wonderful stuff. So there it is, 18th of December till the 12th of January, Baxter Theatre. It's called Dry White. I'm sorry, I can't say it any other way.
I think it's great.
I hope I'm doing it justice.
Yeah, you're doing it justice.
Fantastic. Yeah. And listen, after this, once Jan is done and Giddy Zemba is done and everything, what is the next, let's say the next 6 months hold for you? Do you have any plans, any other special shows? Do comedians plan that far ahead?
I don't even know what I'm doing after this.
What do you...
6 months.
Come on. Fix your life, girl.
I'll tell you what I want to do.
What do you want to do?
This is just my little dream.
Yeah.
I want to go back to the motherland, okay, where my great-grandparents...
Oh, okay, your motherland.
Yeah.
Okay.
Lithuania.
Wow.
Okay.
Okay.
I just featured in a documentary that was aired in Lithuania last week, and I got a message from a comedian saying, interested, can you come and do something?
Oh, wow.
And then I'm thinking about also, because the Jewish people were kicked out of there, and then the Lithuanians took our land. So I'm wondering if I can get a delegation together to see, because we've tried and the willing buyer, willing seller thing's not working. I'm not even joking.
That's amazing.
We're going to get Boppa's house back in Vilnius.
All right, thanks, Nick, thanks, Lindy. Of course, catch Nick Rabinovitz in his latest one-man show, Draw What? With the rising star Lindy Johnson as the opening act, which runs at the Cape Town's Baxter Theatre from tomorrow until the 22nd of January. Tickets will cost you 120 rand, and you can find them at webtickets.co.za.